So is the West being dragged back into a land war in Iraq and Syria?
I don't think there's going to be a land war, no, but there certainly is going to be, if we want to be serious about defeating the Islamic State, there has going to have to be more military engagement. The strikes that are taking place at the moment are good as far as they go, but I think they're largely piecemeal and need to be backed up with a genuinely broad strategy to help defeat the Islamic State.
But we're already very close to, or actually enacting, military strikes by air, by drone against the Islamic State as well. And we have this wonderful term, which I keep hearing, military advisors on the ground, whether it be US, whether it be from the European Union as well. Military advisors means highly trained soldiers. And the difference between military advisor and special forces, can you just explain to me what that is? Because I'm pretty sure that it's the latter that are on the ground already.
Yeah, and I think that the debate will come as to how much those special forces then take a role in actual counter-terrorism operations, actually being on the front line as opposed to just providing training, for example. I think we have obviously in the US and UK extremely capable special forces that would be able to make a real dent in the Islamic State's strength. The question is, are we then willing to take the political ramifications, which is essentially troops back on the front line?
What is the next step on this one? There's an interesting chart that shows the breakdown of where these jihadist fighters have come from across Europe, and actually the largest number seem to be from France, large contingents then from Belgium and Germany and the UK. Cameron, we understand, is set to make some announcement about what will happen with the passports for those that try to return to the UK. Do we not need a more unified or joined up response across Europe to this problem?
I think we do, and this is something that the United States have been very keen to push. The idea that the strength of our ability to stop jihadist attacks such as this is only as strong as the weakest link in the European chain. At the moment, the UK takes this issue very seriously, and with the Prime Minister's new managers, he's trying to take it even more seriously. But I think a unified European approach is one that we're lacking at the moment.
Well, it just won't work without that, will it? Because it's easy to move across borders in Europe currently. Yeah.
And this conflict in Syria especially has been the easiest to get to of any of the recent jihadist conflicts over the past couple of decades because of Turkey. And so we have a very severe problem with this, and it's one that not just people going across to fight in Syria and Iraq, but also obviously people coming back and potentially carrying out attacks in the homeland.
What is the appropriate treatment for those who are returning? I mean, there's a call for passports to be removed and to in effect make these people stateless, but then whose responsibility do they become at that point? And on civil liberties grounds, is that actually something that can be enforced by the government?
Well, we won't be able to make people stateless because we can't as part of international law, but what we can do is, if they're a British national, remove that aspect of their citizenship.